Thank you for purchasing a Juki sewing machine. We hope this DVD will be helpful for you to enjoy your sewing. To ensure your safety, turn off the power switch and unplug the power cord from its electrical outlet in these situations. While sewing, keep an eye on the needle and keep hands away from all the moving parts. The machine socket for foot controller is located in the right-hand side of the sewing machine. Connect the plug of the foot controller into the machine socket and then the wall outlet. Press the power switch and then the power light will turn on. The sewing machine can be stopped and started by using the foot controller. The machine begins operating when the foot controller is pressed and stops when the controller is released. The harder you press the foot controller, the faster the machine will sew. The lighter you press it, the slower the machine will sew. Press down the reverse stitch lever while sewing. Machine will sew reverse stitches. Choose your desired stitch pattern by turning the stitch selector. You can adjust the stitch length by using the stitch length adjusting dial. Set the dial to a lower number for a shorter stitch and to a higher number for a longer stitch. In case the thread tension is not correctly set, adjust the tension by using the top thread tension control at face cover. Set the dial to a higher number for a stronger tension and to a lower number for a weaker tension. For normal sewing, set the dial to 5. For free arm sewing, remove the extension table. As you can see, the accessory parts are stored in the extension table. Turn the hand wheel to raise the needle to the highest position. Remove the extension table. Open the bobbin access cover by pulling it down. With your fingers, pull open the bobbin case latch as shown and take out the bobbin case from the shuttle. Close the latch and the bobbin will drop out of the bobbin case. Place a thread spool to the spool pin and attach the spool cap. Pull some thread off the thread spool. Hold it with your right hand and thread it to the thread guides and through the spring. Then, wind the end of the thread once around the bobbin winder tension disc. Pull the thread through the hole in the bobbin from the inside out. Place the bobbin on the bobbin winding shaft. Hold the end of the thread and push the bobbin winding shaft to right until it clicks. Press the foot controller and start winding. Once the bobbin thread is partially wound, temporarily stop the machine and cut the thread from the hole. Restart the machine and continue winding until you have enough thread. Stop the machine when you have enough thread. The bobbin will begin spinning freely once the bobbin thread is fully wound. Promptly, stop the sewing machine at this time. Return the bobbin winding shaft to its original position. Remove the bobbin and cut the thread. Place the bobbin into the bobbin case. Before putting the bobbin in place, make sure that the thread winds clockwise. Pull the thread through the thread pass and hook it to the thread tension spring. pull out the thread about 10 cm. Fully open the latch and securely fit the bobbin case into the shuttle. Snap the latch shut on the bobbin case. Finally, close the bobbin case cover and return the extension table to its original place. Bobbin setting is complete now. You can begin sewing by picking up the bobbin thread. Always turn the power switch off before threading the top thread. Raise the presser foot. Turn the hand wheel to raise the thread take-up to the highest position. Hold the end of the thread and pass it through the guide sequentially. Hold the thread with your right hand and thread it to the thread guide 1 and through the spring. Then pull it down along the groove. Pass the thread through the thread take-up from left to right. When you come to the guide on the needle bar, pass the thread from the right side. You can now thread the needle. Lower the presser foot and lower the automatic needle threader. Rotate the threader in a direction so that the threading hook goes through the needle eye. Pass the thread along the guides so that the threading hook catches the thread. Lift the end of the thread slightly and hold it lightly between your fingers. Return the lever gently. By doing so, a thread loop passes through the needle eye. Then, pull the thread loop through the needle backwards. To pick up the bobbin thread, first, raise the presser hook and gently hold the end of the top thread. Turn the hand wheel towards you to move the needle up and down once. Pull the top thread gently to pick up the bobbin thread. Pull out both top and bobbin threads and pass them under the presser hook towards the back of the machine. Turn the hand wheel towards you to lower the needle to starting position. Lower the presser foot and press the foot controller to begin sewing. Stop the sewing machine by releasing your foot from the foot controller when it comes to the sewing end. Raise the needle and raise the presser foot to remove the fabric. Then, cut the threads. To change the sewing direction, stop the machine just before the point where you want to change direction and continue sewing slowly until you reach the exact point where you want to change direction. When you get to the point you want, lift the presser foot with the needle left in the fabric. Change the sewing direction, then lower the presser foot again and start the machine. To sew reverse stitches at the sewing start and sewing end, lower the reverse stitch lever at the desired point. The machine will sew reverse stitches while the foot controller is being pressed down with the reverse stitch lever being lowered. You can change the stitch lengths by using the stitch length adjusting dial. Set the dial to a lower number for a shorter stitch and to a higher number for a longer stitch. To set your desired zigzag widths, turn the stitch selector between straight stitch and maximum zigzag stitch. Turn the dial to maximum zigzag stitch for a wider zigzag stitch and to straight stitch for a narrower zigzag stitch. Use buttonhole foot for this stitch. Turn the power switch off before changing the presser foot. Raise the presser foot. Press the presser foot release lever to remove the presser foot. To attach the new presser foot, align the pin on the presser foot and the groove on the presser foot holder. Carefully lower the presser foot holder with the presser foot lever. Attach the buttonhole foot and pull the foot toward you as far as it will go. Lower the presser foot after aligning the needle with the sewing start position. Set the stitch length adjusting dial to the buttonhole stitch marking. First, set the stitch selector to number 1 of the buttonhole stitch and sew the required length. Next, set the stitch selector to number 2 and make 4 or 5 stitches from side to side. Next, set the stitch selector to number 3 and sew reverse stitches to the point where you began sewing. Finally, set the stitch selector to number 4 and make 4 or 5 stitches from side to side. After you finish buttonhole sewing, remove the fabrics and cut both threads. Use the ripper to open the buttonhole. Using a stopper pin as shown will prevent you from cutting the stitches. The buttonhole is complete now. Turn the power switch off before changing the needle. Use household sewing machine needle. Turn the hand wheel until the needle comes to the highest position and lower the presser foot. Next, loosen the needle set screw by using the special screwdriver which comes with your sewing machine. Then, turn the needle set screw and remove the needle. Hold the needle with its flat part facing away from you and insert it fully until it touches the stopper pin. Then, securely tighten the needle set screw. We hope that this DVD has given you a better understanding of your new sewing machine. If you have any further questions, please refer to your instruction manual. We hope you will enjoy your sewing!